So Webflow recently released the MCP server, great way to handle your project or work with your project through your AI platform or AI tool. In my case, I use Cursor, so this is a very, very good tool for me. MCP stands for Model Context Protocol, and this is something that helps you connect a tool to your AI platform, in this case, Cloud or Cursor. So basically, we're going to be connecting our Webflow project to Cursor so that on Cursor, I can handle stuff on my Webflow project. Now, for now, it's a bit limited. You can handle your data points. You can handle your CMS items. You can update content or CMS items. You can publish sites. So let's have a look at how this works. So this is the developer's page. I'm going to leave a link to that in the description below so you guys can check it out. Basically, you go here to Webflow MCP server. It talks a little bit about it. And as you can see, it goes on Cursor or Cloud. And then this is how you install it. First, you'll need to get an API key from your account, and then you will install your API key in this snippet, and then you copy this snippet here to add it to your, let's say, Cursor. So let's go back to Cursor. As you can see, if you go to settings, if you go to Cursor settings, and then you go to MCPs, you can add a new MCP here. If you have other MCPs installed, then you just need to get this part here from where it says Webflow up until the end of it. And of course, add your Webflow token. If not, then copy the entire MCP server snippet with the MCP server header. Once you have that installed, you go back to settings. You can see that you have here Webflow or whatever you named it. And then you can see the green dot. This is working. It's enabled. Great. These are the tools or the functions that I can be using. So we can do pretty much what an editor would do. So if you, let's say you have an editor access to the account, basically this will allow the AI to do that for you. So let's test this out. So I have a project here. I have this project. It's called Arrakis, and it has a CMS collections, and then it has this blog posts collection. So let's go to my cursor. And let's start by telling it, I want all these articles with the number and the name. I want these removed. I don't want these articles. Let's give it a voice prompt. On my project, Arrakis on Webflow, in the collection blog posts, remove all the articles that has a number and the name. All right, so let's just fix the name, Arrakis on Webflow. That will be Webflow. Anyway, so now, as you can see, it's calling the tool. It's doing the functions. First, it gets the sites, then it gets the collections. And here it listed out all the items that has a number in the name. And now it's going to go ahead and delete them or archive them. I think it's allowed to archive. It's not allowed to delete. All right, so now it's done. Would you like me to do anything else? Let's go back to my project. Let's refresh. If you go to blog post, you can see that it archived the ones with a number. That's great. I mean, this is very nice. I mean, in this case, there weren't many articles, but imagine that you have so many and then you just want to filter out or research or adjust some of them based on a certain pattern that is not very common. Let's see if we can update further. So I want to update the main images or the thumbnail images of these articles. So let's give this a try. I mean, I haven't tried this one, but let's see. For the remaining three articles that are live, change the thumbnail image to something unique, beautiful, and free. All right, so let's see what it would do. So I wanted to change the images on the articles that are live. So these three articles. So let's see what it does. So it detected the three live articles. That's great. And now it's adding the images. Okay, so it says I have successfully updated the images. Let's check these out. Super exciting. So now if you can see queue to publish, we can go and you can see that it changed the thumbnail images. So we have a new thumbnail image here that's acting. So that's great. Now this is a simple use case. We're going to be doing much more with this. I'm trying to manipulate the MCP server itself so that we can add more. I want to be able to manage my assets, manage my Webflow project mainly. But for now, this is there. Looking forward to more updates from Webflow. See you in the next video.